and I continue to appreciate, just like fine art.
Once upon a time, you might have joined Jerry Wiegert in his storefront laboratory and been part of the creation of the Vector W8. For you and Jerry Wiegert, those days are gone. The W8 is now a fully developed production car, and Vector Aeromotive is a solid corporation.
The Vector AWX-3 was a code name that I used to designate a new generation Vector. Recently, we were featured at the National High Technology Transfer Show that was put on by NASA Tech Briefs, which is the magazine for the National Aeronautics and Space Administration. And we were featured as guests of NASA at that show, and Admiral Trulli, that introduced the opening of the show, used Vector as a showcase example for the concept of taking aerospace technology and applying it to Earth-oriented application. The concept of the company was always to have a product line. This new WX-3 is that. It represents an all-new body architecture. It represents an all-new design statement for the company. And it provides a fresh, new, stylish, up-to-date presentation for the company. The new vehicle design, the Vector WX-3, complements the existing Vector by taking that vehicle many steps beyond.
Of course, the most radical departure with the AWX-3 is the drivetrain. The engine package is now a four-valve per cylinder double overhead cam unit. The four valves per cylinder allow the engine to rev about 1,000 RPM higher than it did previously on less cam duration, which actually means that it will be easier for us to get through emissions, and its tractability and drivability at the lower end is quite a bit improved over what it is with the two-valve version.
The heart of the Vector Avtech WX-3 is an all-new, all-aluminum, four-cam, four-valve per cylinder, 7-liter V8 engine. The engine is a 90-degree V8 block. The four valves per cylinder are actuated by dual overhead cams, belt-driven, running in one-piece aluminum heads. The valves are extremely short and light, reducing inertial forces and unlocking a potential for extreme revs. The combustion chambers in the Vector AWX-3 are a Hans Hermann design featuring an asymmetrical chamber. The major combustion space is concentrated under the two exhaust valves, resulting in low cylinder head temperatures with quick, smooth combustion. Aluminum alloy pistons run in replaceable liners in this big 7-liter block. Compared to the 6-liter W8 engine, the AWX-3 has less connecting rod angularity and a change in piston design to reduce thermal loads on the upper piston ring in the twin turbocharged version. Horsepower in the prototype engine is phenomenal. 600 horsepower from the normally aspirated prototype on the dyno. And it's anticipated that with development, that will go to 700 brake horsepower. The twin turbocharged version is capable of 1,200 horsepower. RPM capability? 9,000 RPM. The turbo system consists of twin water-cooled Garrett Air Research H3 turbos with automotive center sections and aircraft-specific impellers and housings. The AWX-3 engine is equipped with the Turbodyne system for total elimination of turbo lag, enhanced throttle response, and controlled induction. The Turbodyne unit contributes to better exhaust gas scavenging and improved combustion efficiency. The handcrafted aluminum intercoolers are brilliantly polished and are designed to prevent losses in volumetric efficiency by cooling the air-fuel mixture. Maximum boost is restricted to 12 pounds by waste gates. The induction system is a modular, Vector-engineered system featuring custom-made Bosch injectors and electronic injection. The system is designed so that all the injectors slide in and snap together in unison when the fuel rail is pushed into the plenum. The ignition system is crank-fired with an individual coil for each spark plug. All components are heat-resistant and are packaged under the large plenum chamber. all electrical connections to the engine are via mil-spec cannon-type plugs. The engine is transverse-mounted, cantilevered off the back of the rear bulkhead on machined aluminum plates and triangulated by a fifth mount from the transverse crossmember. Mounting plates are rubber-mounted to the bulkhead, and the engine is triangulated in all three axes. Exhaust headers are stainless steel, as is the exhaust system downstream of the turbos. Expansion joints are all IndyCar bellows type. The emission control system is a closed-loop injection catalytic converter design.
So the interesting part about working here at Vector is that you feel that you're part of automotive history, that rarely does one have an opportunity to work with a company that's associated with such high levels of technology, such levels of innovation, and working at the pinnacle, the arete, if you will, of automotive excellence. This is what I envision the future of Vector to be, is crossing over into other bounds and taking technology from other areas of other industries, from other manufacturing sources, and relocating it and repositioning it.
The quality control standards that we apply are equal to the ones applied in the aerospace industry. And that's quite unique because there is no other vehicle on four wheels that is built like that.
The basic philosophy, of course, behind the first generation Vector and now the second generation still remains the same. Concept was that America has a lot of unique aerospace technology that it can apply to an automobile. Everybody knows that America builds the best advanced tactical fighters. And so the idea was to make use of that technology that exists basically in Southern California is the hotbed of American aerospace. A number of the pieces that we have specially fabricated, sending them to the same types of inspection houses that inspect aircraft parts, and they actually receive a mil-spec certificate to check for weld integrity ultrasonically and magnaflux for cracks. It's that type of a philosophy that prevails throughout the entire line of Vector automobiles, and that continues even further in our new generation, the AWX-3.
You know, airplanes utilize the best in all equipment, in building and design and material, and when you take that technology and put it on the road, there's no question you're going to have a better product, both reliable, durable, and just better sound engineering all the way around. There's no question the chassis and frame development that Jerry Wiegert's done with the Vector is unsurpassed by any standard, whether it's production car or even the most state-of-the-art race cars I've driven.
The AWX-3 also has 18-inch wheels and tires. The previous car had 16-inch wheels and tires. And of course, suspension geometry is always designed primarily around the tire.
The chassis of the AWX-3 is a rigid aluminum and steel semi-monocoque structure with integrated chrome moly steel roll cage. Floor panel is aluminum honeycomb, while the monocoque structure is epoxy bonded and riveted with 5,000 stainless steel rivets. All chassis structures are fabricated by hand on sophisticated aircraft engineered jigs using aircraft quality materials, following aerospace procedures, meeting military spec guidelines. The prototype has been fitted for its Geneva debut with Dedion rear suspension with upper and lower trailing links, diagonal, lateral link, adjustable Koni tube shock absorbers, and an adjustable anti-roll bar. All similar to the W8 suspension in production, except that the steel bearing supports in the Dedion tube have been replaced by aluminum to significantly reduce weight. A fully independent rear suspension is under development for production model AWX-3s. Front suspension uses the proven W8 design with upper and lower A-arms, coil springs, Koni shocks, and anti-roll bar.
The body styling, you'll notice, is radically different. This is to help both aerodynamics and high-speed stability. The rear wing on the AWX-3 has servo electric flaps, which actually deploy a secondary portion of the wing much in the same way that a flap deploys to create extra lift on an aircraft that actually raises above the surface and allows the airflow to go around it in a way that will generate extreme amounts of downforce. Airflow management around the car and into all those heat exchangers and out are the reason for many of the ducts that you see. They're actually inlet and exhaust ducts for the heat exchangers.
The instrumentation system in the vehicle is a four-menu display similar to that found in an advanced tactical fighter. It's a menu-driven display. It reads out all the pressures and temperatures and various other vehicle systems. All of the push buttons in the vehicle are right straight out of the cockpit of an F-117A or a F-16, same vendors, same suppliers, same mil-spec numbers. It has an hours meter for the engine. There's a built-in compass. It has all aircraft warning lights. It has a heads-up display interface. And instead of the typical inexpensive fuses that automobiles have, it has a panel related to circuit breakers, kind of like you would find in any space shuttle or any modern fighter aircraft or corporate jet.
We are in the process now of producing about 1.5 cars per month. In September of 1991, we began developing a new model. In a very short space of about 5 months, we've been successful in developing a second model, which will debut in Geneva. We expect the car to be in production by late 1992. We have two other models on the drawing board. We have the financial wherewithal currently, we believe, to move into production at 2 cars a month. There are no U.S. manufacturer of super exotic sport cars. We believe there's a spot for one, and we believe that we can be successful. We are contemplating an additional warrant exercise in the near future that should net the company an additional $7 million. This money will be used to expand our current facilities and expand our production to increase our marketing effort and to move into the next stage of production. Ultimately, our goal is to produce a more expensive car in limited quantities and ultimately to produce a car at the lower end of the market, which will bring a lot more players into the market. We think this is a formula for success. With our current business plan, we have covered most of the difficult road. We have brought this car through development to the point of production. So we're looking for a bright future. The opportunity for growth and appreciation on this stock is just tremendous.
The concept was to use the finest technology in America, that of aerospace technology, and incorporate it into an automobile where the cost is no object, no compromise type philosophy. The idea was to build a high quality, built to last machine that would endure the life of the man that bought the vehicle.
Following a long tradition of world automotive premieres, we have chosen the Geneva International Auto Salon as the auto show to introduce our latest creation.
I would like to have my lovely fiance remove the cover from the car.
Hi.
What's significant to me is to be here today representing the United States in the supercar market segment. Vector represents the only company in America that's in this market segment. The Vector had the highest DOT certification requirements or results in reference to crash testing, roof crash testing, side impact testing. It never failed a single destructive test, and it was the only car in the history of the DOT to pass the front and rear crash tests on the same vehicle. This car represents aerospace technology for the street, right down to the bone, right down to the details.
We provide carriages and fine motor cars for heads of state and royalty throughout the world, including 9 continuous reigns of British monarchy. The keynote of the success of Hooper through that long history has been to build on creative, innovative design and a pursuit of engineering excellence. All those virtues, I believe, are exemplified in the attitudes and the product of the Vector Company. It's therefore our pleasure and privilege to be appointed the first European distributor of this fine product and offer to the partnership the same level of customer satisfaction and after-sales care that we provide currently to our Rolls-Royce and Bentley clients throughout the world. All the team at Hooper therefore wish the Vector team every success in this courageous and exciting venture into our European market.
We're proud to be here at the Geneva International Auto Salon for the second consecutive year, and we're proud to be here with a line of cars, the Vector W8 and the all-new Avtech WX-3.
This is the only car, to my knowledge, in the world that's a truly hand-built car.
It's almost a romance that happens to you because if you like automobiles, if you really love them, then you appreciate the old, but it's wonderful to be able to admire something totally new.
What Jerry Wiegert's done with Vector is he's taken a radical departure into the aerospace aircraft industry, and he's taken all that technology and he's brought it down to four wheels. And what we have here is an airplane without wings.
The maturity of this automobile represents to me the future direction of the company. I've been in the automotive business for more than 20 years, and I have seen, tested, and driven most of the cars that are out there, including most of the exotics, such as the Bugattis and Ferraris. And as far as I'm concerned, there isn't one of them that begins to approach what Jerry Wiegert has created with this car from the standpoint of the no-compromise design and the ability to put technology into this automobile.